Hello and welcome back to Balthazar's Dream. I'm playing with a ball and doing a dog. Nope, gonna take that sentence back. Hello and welcome back to Balthazar's Dream. I am playing with a ball and playing with said ball with the dog. There we go. That's a, I guess, a better sentence. I can't. Ball's gone, yeah. What can I... What could I do? There's not... Okay... Yeah, I can't make that, so... Nope, contact kills me. Okay. No, just that's just throwing it. What is I am not. Oh. Okay. I asked for this. Okay. I asked for this. What? Is this just nothing? Do I need the ball for it? Okay. Oh, okay. I can see. So it became. Okay, I got it. It's like a kind of like a dog magnet, where I have to chase it if I see it, so I get extra height. Yeah, I get extra height. Okay. All right, that's interesting too. That's something taking, I mean, obviously, dog and turning it into a nice little, I guess, mechanic. I'd call it a mechanic. Just to be, you know, like, different on that front. Oh, no, dang. Get him, yeah! Can't, there we go. Save! Alright. Oh, nope. Okay. I gotta do a jump or something off of this. Nope. Oh, there we go. Okay. Well, now I understand why he spins. Okay. Nope. Nope. Dang. Oh, I'm back here. Oh, that stays. Okay, cool. Whew, Alright, this is getting a little more complicated then. Which is good. I have no complaints about that. Come on. I like those segments of you could die if you stop, but if you keep going, you're fine. That's good. I like that. We're in trouble! The only way ahead is blocked by the meanest, fattest cat I've ever seen! So, boss fights, I assume. Don't worry, it's Cthulhu! Cadkin? Like the Kraken? You're the bravest dog I know! You're a dog! Alright. Oh, crap. Furry is catastrophe. Linux, the fat cat. Okay. Ooh, yeah, one hit deaths is gonna be a little tough on this one. Okay. And it's gonna use cat projectiles. See, the fact that I can't see him from the start doesn't lend it well to me figuring out his patterns, his any kind of AI. Because if he's jumping over here to the left to begin with every time, that's fine. I can figure that out. But from the right on, it's not exactly the most helpful thing. If all he's going to be is not helpful in me orchestrating how to beat him. Drop the ball. Come on. Nope. Jump down somewhere. No, that's not great. This segment here. That's not good. If he's just gonna keep looping using this one attack that doesn't allow me, yeah. That's not cool. That's not good. That is just using a move against me that I literally cannot win against. Over and over is not fair. When my main way of getting to him is powered by the thing I can't do anything against. Maybe I can get him before, no. He's gonna do his jump, or his roar. There it goes. Ah, so close. Yeah, this segment's... These boss fights are going to be difficult if this is how I'm supposed to do all of them. It's not unintuitive. It's just kind of really unfair if this is how they're structured. For me to go and try to figure out an enemy's AI again and again and again and again and again on a random thing where he has one attack that can stop me from climbing up ladders and doing the things I need to get around is it's not right. It's not fair. Especially if he can spam it and keep doing it over and over, just makes it especially hard when I can't get up there in the first place, since it knocks. Like, he's gonna do it again. Like, he pushes me away a little bit, and then the cats don't help here. And of course they don't help here, because I'm supposed to use the ball in order to knock him away, but if I get rid of the ball, I can't attack the boss. These boss fights are not the best. I can tell already. If I can get him... Oh, no. That'd have to have decently good timing in order to get him one cycle on that one. I can see this being a speedrun... A speedrun heavy technique. Screw you, cat. Finally. Yeah, see, I had to go and game it. Get it as fast as I could when he was on the ground and I could easily reach him. Which is, frankly, unfair. That's not right. If it was just spam of the cats that I could deal with every so often, that'd be different. But since it was not just that, and it was much more complicated, unfortunately, due to the fact that he kept doing over and over and over the big yell, which I can assume it's one of his two attacks. It's fine, I guess. But if he didn't do it as much, the boss fight would have been more manageable. And I assume that that's because, oh, it encourages longer playtime on people who can't figure it out. But that's just, I was getting frustrated by the fact that it was happening at inopportune times and I couldn't get to that point. Or else. Couldn't get to the point where I could get to him on the third one when the first two were so easy. I have to fix this. Courage, Balthazar. After them. Yeah, as I was saying, it's not a fair boss fight, which is fine. You die in one hit. It's not necessarily going to be fair, but it's not as good as I had wanted it to be there, I guess.
You look distressed. Are you lost?
It's probably going to be like that on the majority of the boss fights, and that'll be unfortunate, but if the platforming sections are decent enough, I could maybe forgive it. But if maybe the boss fights are varied and different, we'll see. That was just the first boss, and if they are all different, that could be good, but we'll have to wait and see on that one.
Use the magic glass. Good luck, Balthazar. If you need help from us, sound the horn.
Am I gonna get more buttons now? Save points. Excellent! What? Oh! Alright. Okay. This definitely changed that up. I have to learn a whole new set of mechanics and what to look for on this kind of thing. Okay. So the pale ones bounce. The berries are poisonous. That's all. Or the vines or shrubs, pricker bushes. I have no idea what it's trying to convey. But it's conveying something that I'm not supposed to touch or I will die, which is fine. Nope. That was my mistake. Jumped too late. And a lot of this, the platforming sections, it's not like it's bad mechanics and bad physics or bad platforming or anything. Any of this is my own fault, which is fine. I'm totally okay with that. Say things are going to be more like the main boss fight there that happened. If they are a lot like that, that would be kind of unfortunate. I keep saying that. Let me go back to what I'm doing now. Having to learn every level a new set of platforms and things that are okay to do and things that are not okay to do, that's not bothersome. And I hope it doesn't... those could probably hurt me. I'm gonna act like Medusa heads or something. Nope, missed it. But I mean, as long as the things are clear enough, which obviously they are because it's just intuitive of me jumping on platforms that are a different color than the background, is fine. Okay, I can see two things. I assume a star and a rocket ship. Oh, it's a frisbee. That's what that is. Okay. That must have been a hell of a throw. It has Dustin scent on it. I've got to fetch it. Perhaps I can use that metal cylinder. What? Oh, the rocket. I saw humans taking its space on a picture box. Okay. Let's jump up and around and... Oh! Okay. That was very... I guess the first one was long because it was introducing... things to it, and now there's the combination of things that will hurt me and can also take my dog's senses away, which is the natural progression of video games. Nope. Gotta wait and have the boar push me. Yeah, aw, oh, dang. Yeah, I get enough of a speed boost off of that that it works. Nope. But it's gotta happen just like that the other time that had happened. I'm gonna give it another try or two. Nope. Missed that. Alright, okay. I'm gonna continue that one next time. This is interesting. This is taking a different direction than what I originally thought it was gonna be. But that is not necessarily a bad thing. Okay, then I'll have more to say next time. I'll be playing this for a little bit, taking whatever on it. So, this is Richard playing Balthazar's Dream, and yeah, let's continue next time. Thank you.